Good afternoon and hello. My name is Renee D. Waring and I am the founder of Uniquely and Wonderfully Made Ministries. The title of my presentation today is COVID-19-Mental Illness Part 1-R-WARRING. My videos can be found on the following social media sites. On LinkedIn under Renee D. Waring, on Facebook under Waring Communications, LLC, on Twitter under @ReneeWaring, and on YouTube under smallcase r.smallcase WARRING. Mental health issues often coincide with a unique set of challenges that make it difficult for people to access even the basic necessities such as food, medication, stable housing, and health care. Because of all of the previously mentioned factors combined, people with severe mental illness are at a much higher risk of contracting and transmitting the new coronavirus. Some severe mental health diagnoses are as follows: schizophrenia, bipolar, and depression. Dr. Femi Metsuishi, director of the University of California, San Francisco, ZSFG division of Citywide Case Management of San Francisco, said, quote, "We are talking about a population that struggles with being housed, being able to feed themselves, being able to take care of medical issues, having not having enough income," unquote. "The people don't have smartphones, laptops, or access to televisions, so they rely on healthcare clinicians to get the latest updates about the pandemic. There also means that in this time when mental health professionals and clinicians have started consulting with their clients remotely, those who do not have a device don't get the care that they need. People who misuse substances have increased susceptibility to infectious diseases because they are more prone to risky behavior. These prevent people from taking proper safety, self-esteem, and social distancing measures. The rates of smoking among those who have mental illness is much higher than people in the general population. It is about 60% to 70% who smoke. This increases the risk of asthma, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease or COPD, diabetes, hypertension, heart disease, and poor cholesterol is pervasive among this population, which is our key high risk factors for serious COVID-19 complications. Quote, "Their biological age is much higher than their actual age. Our clients are at very high risk categories for complications from most illnesses, and COVID-19 is one of them," unquote. This is said by Dr. Carrie Cunningham, the medical director of Citywide Case Management. She also said, quote, "Pneumonia and influenza are some of the leading causes of death in people who have mental illness, largely due to underlying lung diseases. Many people who have severe mental illness also have a strong distrust for the healthcare system from previous traumatic experiences, cycling in and out of hospitals. It is common for people to refuse to go to the hospital. There is a stigma of getting respiratory disease like COVID-19. The stigma, which may manifest as a deep shame or embarrassment from getting sick, only weighs on the already heavy stigma people can carry from mental illness. These stigmas can be made even more difficult for them to lift out of their living situation. It's really the stigma that leads folks who have mental illness to shut themselves off from opportunities. One of those opportunities is employment. Quote, psychiatric hospitals will have to rapidly adapt to the ever-changing state of the pandemic. Non-essential activities and group therapy sessions have been postponed. They're going to take medication to be stabilized, and that's about it. There are parts missing for the equation, said by Dr. Rayev Salas, psychiatrist. Because of the cancellation of group therapy sessions, hot meals and medications are being distributed at the front door only. Staff of psychiatric hospitals use personal protective equipment, or PPE. There's a growing fear that there will soon be shortages of not just PPE, but of food and medications too. The workers are concerned about not having enough beds. The number of beds is already limited due to their costs. They are not designated COVID-19 floors in the state mental hospitals, so the virus can spread rapidly amongst the patient population. COVID-19 is more contagious than influenza. Thus ends my presentation for today. My next presentation will air on the second Thursday or Friday of next month. Please view my videos and ask someone to view them also. My videos can be viewed on LinkedIn under Renee D. Waring, on Facebook under Waring Communications, LLC, on Twitter under @ReneeWaring, and on YouTube under smallcase.W-A-R-R-I-N-G. I am the founder of Uniquely and Wonderfully Made Ministries. My name is Renee D. Waring, and I am the warrior warring.